Hello, YouTubers. Welcome to my channel today. We're going to do the sailboat on the distressed wood beach wall art, or beachy art. Just cut out your shapes, and they don't have to be perfect. And then I'm using a mirror color, turquoise, white, and ivory to paint on my cookie. That's how we'll give it the distressed look and the crackle look. Once you get a good coverage, make sure to take your brush and then use the long strokes to go all the way across the cookie so that you don't leave any marks. And here I want to add brown to the edges. I wanted a specific looking brown though, and I didn't find that with regular browns. So I used ivory, AmeriColor ivory, and it gave me the exact brown that I was looking for in its gel form. And then once you have all your cookies painted, you want to just pop those in the freezer for about half an hour before you bake them. Once you bake them, that's when you'll get your crackle effect. We're not going to see it right now, but once it breaks, it breaks apart that paint and gives you just the look you're going for. And don't put any plastic wrap on top of the cookies when you put them in the freezer. It will pull off your color. And here I'm using my white modeling chocolate. I have a video of how to make your small batches of modeling chocolate you can check out. And this is the bright white. But sometimes, especially for shells, I will use just a regular white, but I do want the bright white for my little sailboats on this cookie. And I'm going to leave it kind of a thick piece of dough also. I'm going to roll it smooth. And that's the cornstarch in the little knee-high pantyhose. I have another video on how to do that. And I want to let that, I kind of rub that cornstarch in with my fingers, and it helps dry it out pretty quick. So I'm just going to cut little triangle shapes with my razor edge. This is a razor that I only use for food. And now with the razor edge, I'm going to split each little triangle into four pieces. The small one will be three. I'm going to just give that one a unique shape. And now I'll place them where I want them on the cookie to get a general idea of how I'm going to glue them all down. And I'm just going to glue them down with royal icing. And now we need the boat part of each sail, so we'll roll some of that dough out. I use lots of that cornstarch when I'm rolling these because it helps them to dry a little bit quicker, so that I have a little bit more control over my cuts. I decided to make this one a little bit thicker. It was a little bit on the thin side. That's the beauty of modeling chocolate too. Even after it hardens, you can still reuse it just by heating it up with your hand and re-rolling it out. And that one turned out thinner than the first one. So I'm trying again. So as you can see, you can just work with this until it meets your satisfaction. At last, that looks like it's thick enough. Now it's time to give that boat some color. And I'm going to use the ivory again because that's the brown that I like. And since I only need a little, I'm just using the cap top and dipping my brush in that and then painting onto the boat part. Just takes a very little. And there you have it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have anything that you would like to see me make, please comment below. I try to make everything that you want to see. Enjoy!